No, she's going to get clobbered if she plays the ball at all.
Game one.
One new ball first. Hingis is going to have to scamper after an awful lot of drop shots in the next.
Still growing as a player.
Game one.
Played that with some authority. Okay here. Graf serving 3-4 first set.
15 left.
Bang.
Oh dear.
Be sure of finishing it off.
Love 15.
And as you know, I think she's got a
final forehand. Where she may decide she has to come in. Merrily at dawn.
15, this girl. Well, she did exactly the right thing tactically. She got in position for the volley, because she doesn't volley enough. She wasn't able to play all it needed. These are big girl points, these. This is at the very... Even that hit the top of the tape. Away goes the racket. Generally, I'd say that if you persevere long enough, fate levels things out. But at the moment,
into the net, though.
Off now, or at least it might be paying off now, because I think she's tired. No question about that.
Croft's gotten under her skin.
That was down in the end to fitness and strength of character. Yes, over here they'd call this a phenom against a legend. It's not just all the running that Hingis has had to do, and also it's not just all the frustration she's had with so much bad luck on the set point.
Timing of Hingis.
Good, a bit of a revival here by
Shadow Graf.
Croft 2-1.
Times in this tournament already.
Volley at last, but that comes on the forehand. That's the difference. Pingy stopped smiling about half.
Wonder.
Yes.
In this tournament, at least.
Wow. 7-5-3.
Game set.
An hour and 33 minutes. It was really, in the end, I think, all about the first set, for which the 15-year-old miraculously had 5 set points and was very unlucky on 2 of those points.